That's right. You know, when someone thinks of AI machine learning, you think of this scientist in a coat, you know, in front of a whiteboard, a chalkboard, and those algorithms are scary. I've seen you dissect a few, and you know, they can be quite lengthy and intimidating. But you know, what I realized after running my last startup was, it's actually get the data. We realized, like, no matter how good your data science team is, or no matter how good those PhD modeling people are, they can't do anything unless they can access the data. And then the other surprising thing to me, in doing your course and other courses too, I've realized, it just takes a few lines of code and you can implement an existing algorithm. And some of these algorithms are really powerful. And you don't need to go reinvent the wheel. In fact, that's probably the worst thing you can do. You literally might just want someone who can access the data, clean the data, and type a few lines of Python code, and boom, you've performed the work that previously humans couldn't do. Even teams of humans couldn't get to the output a machine can get to.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think in that case, sort of, you know, what we were trying to achieve with the course seems to have been a success. You know, we are in this era of sort of open source, right, technology. So you're absolutely right. You shouldn't be writing new algorithms. You should be sort of implementing what other people have already written. A, because it's more time efficient. B, because there are some smart guys or teams of smart guys out there, you know, making sure it's correct and keeping it up to date and things like that. And so you're right, you know, get the data in a format that you know, a team of people could do the applications for. And once that's all there and it's cleaned up, you know, running the model, in any data science activity, you know, getting the data together can be 80-90% of the time. And then running and optimizing the model is probably 10-20% of the time. That remains true.
And you know, I'd say there's a third thing too, and that is, you got to remember there are teams of experts out there. Some are scientists and PhDs, and others are, you know, working at Google or Facebook, and they're producing powerful algorithms with lots of resources, and they're open sourcing that. The community is very powerful. So I can't really think. Can you think of any instance where it makes sense to go and hire like a PhD level researcher and write algorithms and models? To me, I don't see many use cases in real estate, or if there are, the very edge. What are your thoughts?
So real estate, I will say, so one of the reasons that we did launch the course was just because, you know, we are in this open source era, and you can download all these algorithms. But the sort of specialized domain-specific code for running some things in real estate, we don't see any, like, libraries or packages that you can directly import. I don't know if you need, like, a PhD-level researcher, but someone who understands what they're doing, be it master's or be it because, you know, they've just really geeked out about this for a long time and studied that, that's fine too. But somebody who can convert some of this into a library of code that you can use. That's part of the stuff that we do in the course as well, right? So we do share some of the things that we've coded up. But yeah, if you are trying to do something specific in the real estate space, there are a couple of cases in which, you know, there is something new. There's a little bit of innovation. I'll give you another example. There's a little bit of like, how do we use, say, image recognition for real estate? So we have companies that are looking into maybe grading the quality of a property based on looking at the photos from a listing. We can think about companies like Foxy AI, Resby.ai, and so on. So yes, there is a bunch of open source stuff about image recognition, right? And we can identify, say, a cat from like thousands of photos, right? But it's a little bit different, this question in real estate, right? Like, how do we determine the condition, right? And so, yeah, maybe there is very specific examples like that. Another example, again, image recognition, floor plan analysis, right? How do we automatically recognize from a JPEG or a PDF, you know, the various rooms inside the floor plan or the total size, right? Seems to be still an unsolved problem. So if you're trying to solve really specific cases like that, sure. But I think for the most part, what people are trying to do doesn't necessarily require that. It requires somebody to take the existing algorithms and try to solve it.
Yeah, that focus on data is, you know, it's not a glamorous role either. You know, it can be quite of a boring role sometimes for many engineers. And that's probably why it's been difficult for you know, my last startup, hiring good data engineers was the most important thing we could do. And also, companies tend to kick the can down the road with this. When their architecture isn't in the right place, when data is, you know, The data integrity isn't being respected. It's being stored in different places. It's a lot more work to unchain everything and redo the architecture. And sometimes that's what's needed. Before you can put any of that ML to use, garbage in, garbage out. If the data isn't clean, if the data isn't being even collected and stored properly, that's where you've got to focus. And that's not an easy job.